Hey guys, welcome back to another video of Fox Android. So in today's video, we're gonna learn how to make a QR code scanner in Android Studio, right? So how will you design it? What all libraries are needed? And we'll do the front end and the back end, all those things, right? So now I'm gonna first show you that at the end of this video or this series of video, most probably it will be two videos. What we're gonna get, right? So I'll take you to my mobile screen. Okay, here you can see my mobile screen, right? Here is this QR code scanner. If I just open this. Okay, so at the very first startup, it'll ask for the camera permission, right? As you know, for scanning the QR, we need the camera permissions. So first of all, I'll deny this. If anyone presses on deny, okay, it'll make this dialog box which says please provide the camera permission for using all the features of the app. If we click on proceed, then again the permission is being asked, right? If we press on this don't ask again and deny, so it says you have denied some permissions, allow all the permissions, go to setting and permissions. If we go to settings, app permission, provide the permission, come back, open the app. Okay, here you can see that my camera has been started. So I have just made a QR code on the QR code this scanner, right? Here you can see this website. So I have written QR code tutorial by Fox Android. I'll just scan this QR code. Okay, here you can see this nice pop-up is there. So this is what we'll be getting by the end of this tutorial, right? So without wasting any further time, let's get started. Hey guys, we'll be needing a library for this thing. So I've just copied this library. Here you can see this library. Okay, you can type in this thing and put it in your this build.gradle. I'll just simply copy and paste to save the time. Right after this, we'll click on this sync now button. After this, you go here. I have already mentioned this camera permission. You need to type in this permission because whatever feature you are using which can affect the privacy of the user, or any feature you want to use for the app, you have to mention here in the manifest file, right? After mentioning this, you'll go to your XML file where you want to implement this QR code scanner. So I'll convert this layout to frame layout. Okay, after that go to split screen. Okay, after this we'll just add this layout from the library, the QR code scanner. Okay, we'll set the width to match parent and the height to match parent as well. We'll give it a ID. So here you can see, if I can just show it to you, here is that layout. This beautiful layout is made on this window, right? So now we have to set some attributes. I'll quickly set the attributes, right? You simply need to copy these attributes. There is no logic behind it. It is like that because whosoever has made this library, he has mentioned in his source code that you have to set these attributes for the proper working of the app, right? Okay guys, we have set all the attributes. Now the front end work has been done. So the main task is the back end Java code, right? Now we'll dive into the Java code. Okay guys, we have written the code for the scanner thing, right? I'll just quickly explain the code. So I've made a reference variable for this for the object of the code scanner and named it mcode scanner. Then I referred to the view of that by find view by id, right? I hope this is quite easy. Then I've made an object for that here, right? Then I've set a on click listener, because once a QR code is detected, then the frame will be paused there. So in case you want to again scan another QR code, you simply click on that, and here you can see mcode scanner dot star preview method is called. So it'll again scanning the codes, right? So here is the set decode callback. So this is like when your camera is taking or capturing frames, and whenever it detects a QR code, then this method will be called. You'll get the result, right? So I have raised a toast for that result, but that will not be the actual case in your Android app, right? So you can use the result in whichever way you want to use it, right? So this is how this decode method is called, right? And on pause is when someone like keeps your app in the background, opens up other app, right? So you have to release the resources. So whenever he resumes, then again we'll start capturing it, right? So this is the code required for the scanner thing, right? I hope this is quite easy. But now one more major task is pending that we'll be covering in the next video, that is the permission thing. Because if we do not ask for the permissions properly, or the permissions are denied and we try to run this app may crash. So we have to systematically implement permissions as well. So we'll be covering all that in the next video, right? So I hope whatever I have explained in this tutorial is understood. So I'll suggest you one thing, that before going to the next video, I have made a video on this permission thing. So I would recommend you to watch that video first. You can click on this I button and watch that video. Then you watch the next video, then it'll be more understood, right? Because I might not be able to explain things for the permission in depth here, because I've already explained there. So you please watch that video, then go to the next video, right? So if you have understood all this thing and like the video, hit that like button. If you're new to this channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button and the bell notification icon so that you can get the update of the next video, right? So that is it for today's video, guys. See you in the next video. Bye.